doesn't like to eat freezer food, that doesn't eat outside, who are you going to change among them? Is it Wale that you are going to now turn to start eating what doesn't like to eat? Or is Efe that you now begin to work on to start learning how to cook? Is it this plot? You begin to decide where are you going to start. Now structure now begin to build on your conflicts. We already have, let me ask you a question. If a man doesn't eat this out, do you say it's a problem? As a woman, what will you say? You have to know, because what we are doing is to generate conversation. Because anything that cannot generate people to discuss, you have to create issues that people will make, that make people to talk. And I ask you because you're a woman and you're married. I won't ask her because she doesn't know anything yet.
Because you grew up.
I'm talking about Efe. I won't ask Efe now because she's not married. Yet. Are you hearing me?
I'm not yet, sir.
Okay, continue.
Because.
Okay, your husband agreed to eat this. She eat anything.
Not really anything.
Freezer food, anything.
Freezer food is not, it's not that you have to bring freezer food at the end. It's going to be.
Of course, you want it.
Okay, maybe this Wale grew up in a family where mom always cooks every day.
Yes.
You don't have freezer.
Yes.
So, because of that, to adjust to something new might be a bit challenging for him.
No, I'm just asking, will you say that kind of a thing is a problem?
Or? It's not a problem. He needs to understand that, look, this is my mom. This is another family. I'm coming to, I'm with another person.
Hey, assume you are FA now. You will try to change your husband, not you change
him. Okay, we'll just come to somewhere in the middle. For it at the FA, I'll just know that, okay, I need to learn to cook. Because that is my duty. So husband needs to understand that, look, it might not be possible to always cook every day because of my schedule. So we come somewhere around the middle.
No problem. What I'm just trying to understand now is, you know, we're looking at FA as one conference. We have to look at other characters to whether what we give them as attitude is a problem or not. That is what is called structure. You have to highlight, okay, this is a conflict, because every conflict you create, at the end of the day, you must resolve them. That is the essence of creating structure. And that is why you have a character. We'll still get to that later. Now, you have a team. A team is a major anchor of your thing. Now, the story I told you now is, we're talking about Africans. Yes, Efe might spend most of her life in the UK, but she's still a Nigerian. And our culture demands certain things of a woman. So your team, you must have a distinct team that is guiding your conflicts. So your conflicts must bow to that team at the end of the day. All the conflicts you are going to create will reinforce around this team. And it's at the end of the day, they will bow to you, because this team will not be your upholding, your own moral compass for the people to follow at the end of the day. And that leads you to this. You already create a lot of conflicts here. Not everything will unfold in resolution. Because if you solve everything at once, there's nothing that keeps them going. Along the line, you can be even creating more conflicts. That is what will give you the suspense. That is what keeps people to want to know, okay, what happened next, what happened next, what happened next. Then leads you to when everything I get to scattered. Like everybody now thinking, will there be ever solution to this problem? How many people in Game of Thrones? Okay, which season film do you people watch? You don't watch film?
I do, but not really.
when will you start watching film? Because you are coming to this, you are not watching film, and you are saying not really.
I do, but...
And tell me the one you watch, okay, Mosaic film.
No, no.
Just World because they give me...
War Room.
Okay, War Room. Do you know who... Okay, you know those people who make War Rooms?
What's the name again? Yes.
You know them?
Them. Okay. I know
they are brothers.
Kendrick's brothers, yes.
Kendrick's brothers. They are just three brothers. How many films are they making?
Written
okay. No. Made. Don't know. They made over 10. And all
so
their
how many films have they made? I just said, have you made?
No, no. And all their films, even Despair is a Christian film, is always making box office. And that is even the people that you can follow, even if you're a Christian, if you are planning to start your own Christian, you don't follow these Nigerian brothers and sisters.
Yeah.
You will just be due to brothers. But now, it is this place. You have to build every situation to that level. Once you get to this level, you don't create any more conflicts. Once you get to the climax, that is the highest of the conflict. Every conflict you have created to this level stops. From this level, what you are creating next is solution. Working with all the characters that you have created, then, okay, make your character win or lose out based on the conflict. Then it leads you to resolution. All issues are immediately resolved. You don't leave anyone hanging. Every conflict you have created must be resolved at this level. Now, when you are creating all this thing, I do tell people there is no rules in filmmaking, no rules whatsoever. The only rule is your creativity. There's nobody that said this is how you must write, or this is the style you must use. It's just your own creativity. What makes Tunde Kelani is his own style. What makes Kunle Afolayan is his own style. Everybody, you can come up with your own style. Nobody will question you that why do you go in this direction. There is no rules in filmmaking. You just have to remember what I told you last week, consistency. You can't do something today and just change. The reason why people still respect the lives of Tunde Kelani or Kunle Afolayan is whatever path they have chosen, they remain on it. They don't jump around. Now that takes us to this thing. This is very, very important in creating any good story. Character. I don't tell people, before I write any story, I first create all my characters. If your character is 1,000, you work on them one by one. Give them attitude, give them character, give them relationship. There's something we call every good movie tries on a good and well-informed character. It is based on what you know about your character that you will be able to write what they can do or what they will not do. And people will be able to relate with them based on that. I'll send you all this one later. I just give you. Then the second thing is character map. If you are working with 20 characters, there must be relationship. Who is hating who? Who is loving who? Who is working with who? Who is relating with who? All character must, there's a web you create around all the character that, okay, he is works with Fumi. He is his brother of Tayo or friend. So they must be relating like that. The harrow will connect everybody. So it's not like you just create character because you just need people to fit certain roles. No, you must create what they call this character map, because if your characters don't relate, there's nothing. Now, if you're writing a professional script, there are six major formats that you follow. The scene heading, action, character. I told you I'm going to give you script writing software today. So we'll install it later. Now, this is your six major, and you're following that order.
Sorry, we really was like.
Sorry?
Really was dislike.
Yes.
Yes. Now, the following these formats, you start with your scene heading. This is how it looks like. Now, not necessarily, you might not use this. Most time you might not use this. Most time you might not use this. And mind you, I put this together. There are some scenes that you don't have dialogue. But you need this too. There are some scenes that you need all of it. And there are some scenes that you don't need this. And if you are not professional, if you understand all the basic aspects of filmmaking, you have what they call shots. You know camera angle, but that is not basically part of scriptwriting. It's not your job to put shots. That is the job of the director. But if you also understand filmmaking to that level, because some directors find it very insulting for you to be putting shots in your script. Some directors are that arrogant. You say you can't teach them their job. Do your own job, let them do their own job. But if you are going to be the one that will direct your own script, you can put your shots. But these are the major things that you find in scripting. Now, what do they mean? Is scene heading, as the name applied, is talking about the location where the film is where the action is taking place and the time of the day. You can see it can be exterior or interior. Interior is written as capital IN or exterior written in. But we have to have this because that is what will inform the people where the action is taking place, then followed by what the actor or actress on the set are doing. And like I said, there are some action that will not require dialogue. If your action doesn't, if your scene doesn't require dialogue, you don't need to have the rest.
Script format, is it just for short films or commercials, documentaries?
It's for everything. If you are writing a script for film that we produce, it's the same thing.
Documentary is the same thing.
Yes. As long as people are talking, you are using people to talk, to do certain things, and you are writing what they are saying, it's the same thing. Now, like I said, this parenthetical is something that you can use sparingly if you understand it. Parenthetical is actually talking about before character talks. Maybe your character is like you are doing now, put a hand on your chin and you want that to be captured. Or maybe the person is chewing something. Or the person is trying to clear his throat before he talks. That is what you use parenthetical for. Now, in character, before I go, before I forget, when you're introducing a character for the first time in your action, they have to be in cap. Capital letters. Now, if there's any embassy on any object that you are using, maybe a phone, and you want that phone to be used during shoot, it also must be in capital letters. Every item on that thing that you want the director to notice must be in cap. Anything that you want to create emphasis on. When a director is looking at your action and they saw anything in cap, it's calling for attention. So you must give attention to it. So whatever you want director to give action attention to in your action must be in cap, including the. And afterwards, after you introduce your character for the first time, in subsequent one you can decide to write the normal thing. But if you like, you can still continue in your cap. But if you're using a normal software, once you get to character name, it automatically changes to cap. You don't have to, like I told you last week, you don't have to worry about whether you're changing to anything. Now, let's go to, like this name says, scene heading is not slug line. Some people call it slug line, others call it scene heading. What I explained before, action is character. I just want to rush so we can do something. Now, I told you this last week. In case you are still writing with your word, if you find it, you must put 1.5 inch margin if you are using Microsoft for setting up of your this in a 1.1 inch to the top and 3 point to your left side. So, but that is a lot of work. If you are even formatting the page by yourself on Microsoft, you will spend more time than writing. So that is why it's always good for you to write. And there are, this for now is still the best, but it's more of expensive, but these two are free. This is the one I'm giving you today. Sales. You do the same thing. And I told you last week, the reason why you are using software is every one page equal to 1 minute. So if you are writing a script with a well branded software, it means if you are writing 60 pages, if you discover that your page is 60, it means 60 minutes. Whatever page you have, just times it by minutes. That's what you get. Now, for TV show, this is the simplest form of script. You don't need much. It's just, now, what you just need to do is, for a TV script, your timing, you first want to know, is it going to be a 15-minute show? Is it going to be a 20-minute show? Is it going to be a 30-minute? It's based on that you allocate time. Usually, introduction by host should not be more than 2 minutes. For a 15-minute, then the show begins. That is the real show, what you are doing. All the scripts must not be more than 8 minutes. Then you put commercial break for 1 minute. Then concluding. That means if you are doing a 15-minute show, all the time you are going to use is 10 minutes. The rest 5 minutes, introduction, concluding, and commercial break. But if it's 30 minutes, just that means you have more time for the show. Your introduction and conclusion is not going to be more than 1 minute, 2 minutes. But in the case where you have more than 2 guests, your concluding might be more than 2 minutes. What you just do is give each guest 1 minute. If you have 3 guests, because you said that's 4 minutes. But that is for any show that is more than 15 minutes. Even if you have 20 guests for a 15-minute show, your concluding should not be more than 2 minutes. Otherwise, you don't have time for anything. You will get that. Now, this is the one I was trying to tell you earlier. Here. This is very important also when you are writing the scripts. Like what the idea I asked you to do earlier is, what I need is a film treatment of your film. That is the prose format, to write the story, the full story, not summary. When you are writing an idea, it's the full story you write. It's after you write the full story that you now create your synopsis. You don't write synopsis and you can't develop synopsis. Because you also ask yourself the same question that people will ask. You have to start with film treatment, which is the whole of the film. Then out of it, you create 2 to 3 lines of synopsis. Then you create story outline. That is, okay, what happened first, second, third, as the story progresses like that. Then character analysis, which is what I talked about earlier. Create unique characters. Create new characters and now time to start all over again with your ideas. I want us to shoot the scripts for one of you today. If we have a good one, I was thinking we're going to add a compelling idea to it. Give me another one. Let's start with the list now. The list is easy to write, like I said. You know, one thing is this. Don't just think like all this is for writers and because you want to use cinematography and you don't have to write. No. The more you know, the better you become. Because if you know about script writing, you know about cinematography, you know about, there is no aspect of filmmaking I cannot talk about. You know why? Because I create time to learn every aspect, and I cannot just learn it on the surface. I learn it deeply, and that will give you the aspect to, by the time you get to that level that, okay, you also want to go full blown, people will listen to you when you're talking. Don't just say that, but therapy, you can also decide, okay, I just want to be a cinematographer, and you'll be there. But if you actually want to get everything, you need to go around. I know most of you are just thinking, okay, so writing is just, that is where the real job is. Because you are the one that dictates the tempo of the game. Yeah. And the director cannot come on my set now and just be talking and be analyzing the script the way it's not supposed to. You can call him and say, Ross, come back. That is not the way it should be done. But if you have never even understand what scripting is all about, if the guy is destroying your storyline, then you can't know. When I made my first film in 2015, I told you it was a fire, I don't think it's baptism of fire for me. If it's not, if brimstone baptism, it is for me. Because everything, in fact, that is what even prepared me to come and learn. Because I was thinking then that I'm okay with scriptwriting. I was already a scriptwriter, so all other aspects can just wait. I don't need it. But you know what? At the end of the day, because I spent more than I should have, I'm not supposed to spend half of what I spent. Money wise. I'm not supposed to spend half of what I spent. And at the end of the day, even the team did not even come out the way it's supposed to be. So you don't want to learn that the hard way. Now, let's go through your idea, second idea, please.
So the second idea is like a love story.
There are some things you have to learn. It's nothing like. Okay. It's a story. You are telling us something. And it's your story. If you want us to take you seriously, if you are saying like, at the end of it, it's something that you want us to believe.
Okay. So it is a love story. Yeah. So the concept is the guy and the lady already, the two characters, a guy, a lady, probably, and the best friend of the lady. So along the line, the lady had an accident where she lost her memory and all of a sudden cannot recognize the guy again, but she has just a glimpse that she has one way or the other met this guy before. Then she goes different events happen, rejection. Different events happened, rejection, that's the girl rejecting the guy, like, because she can't remember like, the past. The guy always making efforts to show that, we have been together at a certain point in time, fixed dates, but there's no connection because he's a new person. Then at the end, she gets to remember everything, and they all leave. Ever after.
You know, from the beginning, you already know who are storytellers, who are behind the scene people. You will know that he is not a storyteller, so we should just leave him out of it. Abby, what do you guys say? He's not a storyteller. You already told us from the beginning. So
I can learn.
No, we'll let him do it. Let him tell the story so that when he keeps saying it, he will
learn. Exactly.
The starting point is you are going to follow the format of scripting. You are going to do proper and you are going to read it yourself. Because it starts with you believing what you are talking about, because the way you are telling it is more like you don't even believe it to some extent. Maybe you believe 40% or 45%, thereabouts. And one thing about storytelling is, let me give you an hint. Like, if I tell you, let me use myself as an example. I have an uncle who is taller than Benga when I was 6. He's muscular and so on. So along the line, I always thought when I grew up, I'm going to be like him. Tall, muscular, everybody will respect me. But as time passed out, 20, 25, 30, I still remain like this. And it now occurred to me, like, what did we do wrong? Why didn't I turn out to be my uncle? After he traveled for a long time, he came back like 3 years ago, and I saw him were like, what a pattern. I just remember, every time I remember that thing, it's not a joke. Like, what happened? I have siblings who are half my age now that are even twice my height. I'm just like this, and maybe I have to go ask my mom some questions or something. What do you think?
No, you can help me.
Is that a story you like to watch?
Yeah.
It should be.
It is rather.
You tell a story from an angle that people want to know, okay, let's do some investigation together. What happened? I should go ask my mom. Okay, for me.
Okay. You said we should say the story. And I said the synopsis first.
Let's do the synopsis first of time.
Okay. Okay, the title is Endless Tears. Even when the betrayers, that is Justine's husband, yes, no, and her best friend, Jennifer, show great penitence, it isn't enough to heal Justine's wounded hearts. So things gradually begin to fall apart. The center ever hold anything.
One million photos.
Really?
I told you a story now. My story of like 37 years I just told you. Is that a synopsis?
Yeah, I was saying, should I just say synopsis?
It's your story. You don't have to read it. Just tell us in a way that we understand.
It's about the story of a lady, a husband, and a best friend. On our wedding day, when the pastor asks who is against the journey of these beautiful people, the best friend, who happened to be the chief bridesmaid, raised up her hand, and that was where the problem started. So even when they repented and they were sorry, it was very difficult for her to forgive that this is my best friend, we grew up together, how we should do this. And this is my husband, my husband has been my friend for a while. Why did both of them do this to me? And plea from everyone to forgive them, you know, she couldn't find herself to forgive. So it's based on unforgiveness. It was very difficult. By the time she was really going to forgive, it was already too late. That is so
sorry. Can we have something that will make us laugh?
He just gave us
a comedy.
Okay, is that a comedy? I want to be ready with it.